Scorpion headed on out of the Waiheke Valley towards the shoreline. And as we do so, you'll see the clouds kind of lighten up a little bit, and blue skies come back out again. The shoreline's still about 150 inches of rain here in this area, which is much less than in the back of the valley.
I can see clearly now, the rain is gone.
On the right-hand side, we have Kahului Town, the main town here on the island, the sugarcane fields of the Central Valley as well.
Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. Here is that rainbow I've been praying for.
All these tall sea cliffs you see out here in the northwestern coast of Maui, created by winds and waves. The big waves that come in here in wintertime. Some of the storm systems happen off the Gulf of Alaska. Alaska is straight ahead of us, about 3,000 miles away from here. And we're going to be doing a little turn, so everybody's going to get a good view of these cliffs in just a second. I don't know how far you guys got an opportunity to explore this island of Maui a little, but there's one road that goes all the way around the West Maui Mountains. About a 3-hour drive or so. Alexa, have you been out here on this road that goes around the West Maui? No? It's an incredible drive, really. I mean, the road does get a little tricky, but you don't have to go all the way around in order to see the good things. There's the people come out, here's a little fishing village behind that rock on the left-hand side called Kahakuloa. There's a loop trail that goes along the cliffs there. Then there's also the blowhole that's going off right now. See out in the distance, 11 o'clock, this big little fountain coming out of the water. So the blowhole is a hole in the old lava flow, and as the water comes into the waves, squeezes that water through the hole and shoots up. But that was going off right now again. Let's fly by there. Seems to be all happy today, the blowhole. And then the trail, the loop trail, is right here in the, along the cliffs as well. If you guys, let's say you stay out in Ka'anapali or on Lahaina or somewhere in the area, just takes about a half an hour to drive out here. Tell me, where are you guys from?
We're from San Francisco.
Oh, just across the water, San Francisco. How's your Hawaii vacation going so far, Tommy?
So far, so good.
Yeah. Have you been here before, or is this your first time?
Never been to this island, but been to Oahu, though.
Oh, I see, okay. Oh, Oahu is almost like San Francisco.
It is.
Except there's a little more traffic on Oahu, I'm sure. Good. Amy and Timothy, how about you guys? Where are you from?
Chicago.
Chicago. That's almost the other side of the country, my God. Alexa, how about you?
I am from Maryland, but I'm originally from Jamaica.
You're from Jamaica? Oh, no way!
So from one island to the next.
Oh, that's incredible.
I know, right?
So do you grow up in Jamaica? Did you just move?
Majority of my childhood is from Jamaica, and then I lived 3 years in Europe, in England.
In England? Well, I'm from Austria. Have you ever gone over there?
No, it's on my to-do list.
Oh, you should. It's a good place, too.
Okay.
So here we go. We go from Jamaica to Hawaii to Austria. It's all good.
All right.
So how do you like that island, Maui?
My mom is asking if I should move here.
Does your mom live here?
No, she doesn't. But
she just wants to move here with you.
Yeah, I think she wants me to move, then it's okay for her to come on over.
Hey, that sounds good to me, and you should move here. It's a great place.
Let me think about it some more.
Yeah, you can always come with me, you know, and you just do the tours for me, and I just fly and you talk.
Hey, let's talk.
So after the flight, we talk.
All right, no problem.
Oh, glad to have you on board.
Thanks.
Check out this cliff here on the right-hand side. Is that incredible, the color? Around. Timothy, you like baseball?
Grew up a Cubs fan.
Oh yeah, here we go, perfect. You go to the stadium every now and then, or you have a season's ticket there, or what?
A couple times a year.
Oh yeah, sounds good. Ah, there's all these wonderful stadiums over there I have to visit. It just seems like I never get off this island here.
I don't feel too bad for you, though.
Well, you shouldn't. There's no reason for that. There's no reason to feel bad for me at all. How about hockey? You like hockey, too? You guys have a great hockey team over there.
Ah, there's 3 championships in 4 years.
I know. Can't beat that. Is this your first time in Hawaii, Timothy?
Yes. We came over here for our honeymoon.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
And obviously you guys got married over there in Chicago.
Yep.
You guys have a big wedding?
200 people, so yeah.
Oh, wow. 200 people, huh?
Yeah.
That's incredible. At my wedding, I only had 3 people, my wife and me included. We got married, this is a different story with us, though, because we got married 6 days after we met. And nobody from my family wanted to show up over here, and nobody from my wife's family, because they said, this is stupid. That was 18 years ago. Now, 2 kids later, still married. Wedding anniversary is coming up on the 15th of September, and yeah, it's all good. Wonderful.
Congrats.
Thank you. You know what else is wonderful? This island straight ahead of us. That's where we're going next. This is called Molokai, the second largest of the 4 islands of Maui County. About 7,000 people live over there, so hardly anybody on a huge island. And it has sea cliffs, it has waterfalls, it has valleys. It's absolutely stunning, and as I said, I will show you as we get there. Molokai is a very traditional place. People are mainly farmers, fishermen, cattle ranchers, and hunters. Hunters, they hunt mainly goats and pigs and deer over there at Molokai. Also, the most Hawaiian of all the islands, as they call it, because it has the largest population of Hawaiians, with at least 50% of Hawaiian blood. Also, last but not least, the birthplace of hula, the world-famous Hawaiian dance, started on this island straight ahead of us. Long time ago. Tommy, you guys ever drive down to San Luis Obispo?
Chadwick, but yeah.
That's good too. Yeah, that's where I grew up flying-wise in San Luis. My wife is from there, and I went to flight school there 100 years ago, it feels like, sometimes.
It's a beautiful town. I went to a Defense Language Institute in Monterey.
So oh, you did? Oh, nice. Oh, how nice. That's all the Central Coast all the way up to San Francisco and further on is just absolutely spectacular. I lived there for a while too, and I had a wonderful time in California.
The Bay Area or Maui?
Say it again?
Would you choose California or Maui?
You know, Maui, because I have a little connection with this island. My kids both born here, you know, and And my wife has lived here for over 35 years, and we talk about it all the time. Let's go back to California again, live there for a little bit. But my wife and I and my kids, we travel all the time. So we were down in Southern California just 4 years ago, and I flew helicopters there. Then the last 2.5 years, we lived up in Colorado. I flew mountain rescue helicopters up in the Rockies. But Maui kind of always pulls us back over again. And we have our house here. This is just our base, and we move on all the time. But I wouldn't mind at all to go out to the Bay Area and live up there for a little while, because obviously there's a lot of people coming over from there, and they seem really very nice people too, and I like that lifestyle they tell me about over there, and the wine country and all that. So maybe one day I'm going to be over there too for a little while. Life's too short, you know. There's so many beautiful places you got to get out and enjoy them.
I was just going to say, you lived in some pretty beautiful places throughout the country, so.
Yes, absolutely. So we're going on shore here right now at the Murphy's Ranch, as they call this huge place. It's a big cattle ranch, about, I don't know how many, 28,000 acres, I think, is it privately owned. And we're going to go into the back of Halava Valley, which has a very interesting history, since the very first people that ever settled here in Hawaii, they settled in that valley about 1,500 years ago.